Hæ, ég heiti Ása og verið velkomin á rásina mína að læra íslensku. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, let's learn Icelandic. Þátturinn í dag verður með svolítið öðruvísi sniði. Okay, the episode of today is going to be slightly different because I am not going to teach you so much Icelandic, but a little bit, but not so much. But I'm going to introduce to you the 13 Icelandic Santa Clauses. So in Iceland we don't settle for only one Santa Claus, but we actually have 13 of them. 13. That's how many that we need, or at least that's how many we have. Whether we need them or not is a different story. Internationally, the Icelandic Santa Clauses, they're often called Jólalads. And that is just a more direct translation of the word that Icelanders use for Santa Claus. So basically, we use the same word for the international Santa Claus that you all know and for the 13 Santa Clauses that belong only to Iceland. So if we have one Santa Claus, it's Jólasveinn. And this means like Jóla refers to Christmas and Sveinn refers typically to a youngish man, something like this. So Jólalads is like a natural translation of this. But we also call the international Santa Claus, we call him Jólasveinn. However, these Icelandic Santa Clauses are quite different from the international one. Okay, first of all, they are 13. Or Jólasveinarnir 13, the 13 Santa Clauses, as we say in Icelandic, Jólasveinarnir 13. And not only are there so many, but they each have their own name, of course, and they each have their own personality, and they are, historically, they have not been super nice. So usually they are pranksters who mess with you in a different ways, and their name refers typically to how they make pranks and how they disturb people. But nowadays, with the competition from the international Santa Claus, they have sort of become better behaved. So they still do pranks, but they're also sort of nice as well. So the Icelandic Santa Clauses, they all live up in the mountains, in the Icelandic mountains, and 13 days before Christmas, the first one comes to town. And what he does is that all the children, the Icelandic children, put their shoe into the windowsill. They put the shoe into the windowsill, and then the Santa Claus gives them small presents. The next day, his brother, number two, comes along and does the same. Then they come to town, one after the other, until the last one gives some gift into the shoe that the children get on the morning on the 24th of December. So that's why the most common question for the children ask during this time is Hvað fékkstu í skóin? Hvað fékkstu í skóin? Which means, what did you get into your shoe? What did you get into your shoe this morning? And if you've been good, usually you get a little small toys or maybe some sweets or something like this. But if you have been bad, then you will get a potato, which is kind of lame. So if you have been really bad and the Santa Clauses are not happy with you, they'll put a potato in your shoe and then you can say, Ég fékk. Kartöblu í skóin. Ég fékk kartöblu í skóin. And actually there exists very nice short poems or short verses about each one of these Santa Clauses that are probably called Jólasveinavísur. I'm guessing it's probably called Jólasveinavísur, or like the verses of the Santa Clauses. And this was actually written by my uncle, not really my uncle, but like a distant relative, many years ago. And where he has a small verse about each of the Santa Clauses. So what I thought was, it would be fantastic to do a short video with each one of them and post on the day when they come to town and do all of them before Christmas, and then it would be super nice and super fantastic. But realistically, this is not happening because it's 13 Santa Clauses and I have a job and other things to do, so I'm not going to be able to do all of them. It's simply not possible. So, but instead of doing the all or nothing approach, which is the most Icelandic thing to do in the universe, or in Icelandic we would say allt eða ekkert, So instead of this approach, I'm just going to do at least one Santa Claus and then maybe a couple of more, depending on how much time I have. And then we'll just continue next year. And then after a couple of years, we will have videos of all of them. So I hope that is acceptable for you, because 13, I cannot do it. But in this video here, I'm just going to use the opportunity and introduce their family a little bit, because of course the Icelandic Santa Clauses, they have a family. First of all, they're all brothers. All 13 of them, they are brothers. And they have a mother and a father, like most children do, or at least many children do. And they are called Grila. Grila is their mother. And Leppalúði is their father. And then they also have a family pet. Okay. The family pet is called the Christmas cat or Jólakötturinn. And these people and the cat, they have a big influence on Icelandic people for many reasons. Let me just start with the Christmas cat. The Christmas cat, as far as I understood, is very big, very horrible, black, most likely. Even though I have not seen him personally, lucky me, because what he does is that he eats people if they don't get any new clothes for Christmas. Okay, so if you don't get any new clothes for Christmas, the Christmas cat will eat you. So this is his Christmas dinner. He will eat all the people who didn't get a new clothes for Christmas. So the good news is this, the cat doesn't care if you're buying your new Armani suit or if you're buying $2 socks to him, it doesn't matter at all. You just have to get something new for Christmas, otherwise he will eat you. Or as we say in Icelandic, annars ferðu í jólaköttin. Annars ferðu í jólaköttin. Otherwise you will, literal translation, go into the Christmas cat. So if you're out shopping with your friend and the friend says, ah, should I buy this for Christmas? And then you of course say, auðvitað, ekki viltu fara í jólaköttin. Auðvitað, ekki viltu fara í jólaköttin. Of course you should buy this. You don't want to go into the Christmas cat, will you? You don't want the Christmas cat to eat you, so you simply have to buy it. It's the law. Then there are the parents of the Santa Clauses. First of all, I will start with the father because we know less about the father. Okay, the father is called Leppalúði. Leppalúði. So the second part of his name is Lúði. Lúði. And this is a word that we use similar to the word nerd. In English, nerd or a geek, we can use either nerd, which is just borrowed from English, from the nerd, but we pronounce it nerd, because that makes it so much easier. Or we could describe this person as a lúði. Lúði. So we already see from the name that Leppalúði is maybe not the most outstanding of men. And in fact, he's just a lazy bum, really. He just hangs out in his cave up in the mountains, so we don't really see him so much. He's just there, and he just stays there, and in fact, he doesn't really control anything, not over his sons, or not over Grila, or nothing. He's just very lazy and likes the simple life. Then finally, we have Grila. Okay, Grila, which is the mother of the Santa Clauses, the mother of the Icelandic Santa Clauses. And she is a troll. She is like a troll or a giantess, like a female troll, which in Icelandic we call a tröllskessa. So tröll means like a troll in the general sense, and tröllskessa means a female troll. And you can also use the word skessa about usually a female character who's very loud and not delicate and a bit rah, then you can describe that person as being a skessa. But she is an actual tröllskessa. First of all, Grila is very old. She's very old. She's probably been here long before the people settled in and started living here. So we have stories about her ever since Landnam, or ever since the people started living here. She has many, many, many children, dozens of children. Most of them don't care about humans, so we never see them really. And I think Leppaluði is her third husband, so she has lived a long and eventful life, let's say. We don't really start hearing about the Santa Clauses until many, many hundreds of years later after we moved here, but we don't know if it's because they were not already born or if they used to just stay in the cave with Leppaluði and then suddenly decided to mingle with people. This we don't know, and even if they would tell us, it's impossible to believe those people. They're pranksters and mischievous men, so you cannot believe a single word that they say. But what Grýla does actually, and this is sort of horrible, but she eats children that misbehave. Okay, she eats children that misbehave. And this is kind of ironic because her 13 sons are just about the most misbehaving children that have ever existed in Iceland. But she does not eat her own children, she only eats other people's children that are misbehaving. Okay, so you better not be a bad child, because then Grýla comes and she has a big sack. And then she just gathers all the bad kids into the sack and takes them up to her cave, and then she eats all the bad children. And as you may understand, this is kind of scary to children. So Grýla has been used to scare children into behaving. And it's been to that point that we can also use the word Grýla about anything that is used to scare people. Okay. Anything that's used to scare people, maybe not in a completely civilized or like a moderate way, we could call it Grýla. One example of this could be, you could for example say kommunista grýlan, and that means the scare of communism, sort of scare of communism. And you can basically use it in any way you want. If you're scared of a specific nation, then you could say that. And I could give you examples of this, but I'd rather not, because it's not too nice. And if you're scared of anything that's used to scare people on a large scale, you could refer to it as Grýla. But there's also a nice word that is associated with Grýla, or at least it's a word that I like very much. And this word is Grýlukerti. Grýlukerti, which means Grýla's candles. So Grýla's candles. Can you imagine what this means? It has a very practical real life meaning. And this is icicles. So basically when you see the icicles coming down from the houses or from the cars or whatever, in Icelandic we call that Grýlukerti. That's all for today. Stay tuned if you want to hear more about the Icelandic Jólalads or the Icelandic Santa Clauses. If you want to learn Icelandic, check out my channel, subscribe and all that. See you all soon. Gleðileg jól!